everyone, it's King of Valence. I'm here hopefully making a quick video on how I made the automatic load remover. I'm making this video for one, for just for good general archiving reasons, but two, so anyone can make their own load remover for Spore. And also that might include myself because I might need to check back here in a year and see how I did it. So the load remover that's available right here on resource tab I have available is only works for these versions of Spore and Galactic Adventures. It's the current version on Steam. But the load remover will not work on different versions of Steam, on different versions of Spore, and possibly different operating systems on your computer. So I'm going to show you how to make your own load remover in case you're not using the current version on Steam, because it won't work on the current version of Origin or good old games anywhere else. So I'm going to show you how to make it. All right, let's take a look at the actual script itself. It's actually pretty short. It's basically, this is everything that's there. Very oversimplified, it's looking for a particular memory address in your RAM and sees when it's changing. So when it's changed, the LiveSplit will detect that and pause. But when it's not changing, it'll continue. But this memory address will be different per game and per operating system. So let's show you how to find your particular memory address. Okay, so the programs you'll be needing is Notepad++ and Cheat Engine. If you've never seen Cheat Engine before, I recommend watching a dedicated tutorial on this program because it can be kind of confusing. We'll be doing a lot. But if you're just interested in Spore, you can follow along and you'll be just fine. So thankfully Spore made finding our particular memory address pretty easy. It was trial and error and a lot of hard work to find, but now that I know how to do it, it's pretty easy. So thankfully that when it's not loading, our value is zero. So let's do a first initial scan. So 57 million possibilities is our one particular memory address. So let's do a load, try to narrow that down. So let's load creature stage. When it's loading, the value is one, very convenient. So let's do another scan, down to 44,000. That's pretty good. We can scan a bit. Wait for the progress bar to load a little bit and we can scan again. All right, when it's unloading, we're down to zero, back down to zero. Another scan, 3,000, that's pretty good. Let's get the cutscene. And we can check again. Okay, now we're going down to go to space. This will help us narrow it down a lot. So we're loading again, so we're back to one, down to 86. That's better. So now it's 76 possibilities, 61 possibilities, and 9 possibilities. Can we get better than that? Let's see. They're all zeros. They're all still zero. All right. Part of the load remover also removes loads when leaving and entering planets. So we'll know which one our particular address we want when we leave the planet. So there it is. That's the one memory address that changes when we leave planets and when we load. So this is the particular memory address we want. We narrowed it down from 57 million down to this guy. Now, unfortunately, that's not all we have to do. There's a little bit to find where this originates from. So this address will change every time you load up Spore, but we'll find a way to find the original memory address that this came from that doesn't change, so you can use your load remover script every time you load Spore. So what you have to do is to say, what writes to this address? Let's bring this over here. So you have to make that occur as well. So we know what, so we can actually, so Cheat Engine can find what we're doing. So there we go. So looks like we have an offset of 58. That'll be important in a sec. So let's go more information. It's over here. So we want this particular number right here. If we see from over here, let me get this out of the way. We originally had this memory address, but now we're going to turn it into this memory address. Can I type in here? Okay, so we're going to look. We're going to hex value. We want to look for that memory address in particular. So 14, capital, lowercase, doesn't matter. Let's go AE93 and C0. So we want to look for that. New scan. Give me a new scan for that. There we go. Remember how I said they made it easily? They made it easy for us? Thankfully, it's only one layer deep. This green means we're in the green. So this is the base memory address. If you know more about Cheat Engine, that means more to you, but if you don't, it doesn't really matter. So this is what we'll be using every time. But this also is not the correct number. We have to say what accesses this address. Bring this over here. Let's click on this. And there it is. That's the number we want. So let's go back to our load remover script. See what we have here? 0x, F11, FCC, 50, and remember that offset of 58. Just add those zeros and x's, and it will work. I will say someone did write this script for me. I just gave them this exact number and the offset, and they wrote it for me. So hopefully this will work on with everything else, but this is how LiveSplit reads the script. So all that's important is you have this. This is unique to you in your version. So just follow my kind of setup here, just put in your unique memory address and offset, save it in Notepad++. What you have to do is when you save it, save a copy, you can just save it as a normal text file, just name it whatever, .asl, and it will save it as auto splitting language. So here I'll name it something, for tutorial. So you know this is the same one I'll be using for just to show it works. All right, let's bring up LiveSplit here to show you how you actually integrate that script into LiveSplit. So in LiveSplit, you edit layout, and then you in control you add scriptable auto splitter, which I did. So you double click scriptable auto splitter, and you browse for where you ever saved it. So this is the one I just made for the tutorial. I'll show that that exact one works. Let's get rid of all this. So let's hit go. And we leave the planet, and you see it's paused. Shows that LiveSplit is detecting the correct memory address and will work on all of the loads. I'll show you another one in space, in the space load. Move you. So there it is. It's paused. Also, very important. You have to compare against game time. If you compare against real time, it will not pause the timer. It must be compared against game time in order to pause. So as soon as the loading is done, the timer is back. And it will only pause when that value turns to 1, which we know is during all of these loads. So that covers everything I know about making the load remover. Hopefully that was helpful. If you're playing on a different version than me, where I don't have a load remover for you, and you'd hopefully be able to make one very easily for yourself. Let me know if this works. Hopefully I'll be able to answer any questions. I only really know how to find the memory addresses, so hopefully that script is kind of universal and works with everyone. All right. Thanks everyone for watching. Have fun.